This is the structure of singleton pattern. We'll see how this is implemented in C# source. Here is the class singleton. Here is the data member instance. Type static of class singleton. Here is the data member data of type int. Here is the constructor of singleton class. It's a private, so client cannot create object directly. Here is the static method instance. Inside this, it checks the value of instance. If it's null, then it creates the object of singleton, and here it returns the instance which is assigned with singleton object. Here is the method setData, which sets the value to the data member data. Here is the method getData, which returns the value of data. Okay, let's see the main. Here it calls the instance method of class singleton. So it comes here, and this is first time. So right now the value of instance is null. So it will create the object of singleton and will assign to instance, and here it will return the instance. So now the set data is called, so it will come here and it will assign the value 10 to data member data. Okay, in the next line, the instance method of singleton class is called, so it comes here. Right now instance is not null, so it just returns the instance which has object which was created first time when method instance was called. And here when getData is called, it comes here and it returns the value of data, which is 10, and it displays this statement. We'll run this program and we will see the output. Okay, so first time it creates the object of singleton, it sets the data value to 10, and second time it gets the same instance, doesn't create. Next time the singleton object, and it gets data value which is 10, and it displays it. So we can see when the instance method is called first time, at that time only it creates the object of singleton.